hammer and leash. He was the great editor. They used to send me train fare so I could sit around at night and drink beer and tell stories and smoke cheap cigars and play cards with them. All About Us would be the pages of my latest book. He edited and printed it too. And the old boy didn't pay royalties, but nobody knew who I was, so it was all right. At night I'd have to get more beer. I drank quite a bit, and she'd say, "Why don't you take the dog with you?" And he'd hand me a hammer. "Stick this in your pocket." And out I'd go into the jolly night, one hand holding the hammer and the other the leash. They told me it was a rough neighborhood. No matter where I visited them, it was a rough neighborhood. The French Quarter, the alleys of Santa Fe, Tucson, along roads without sidewalks. They had me looking back over my shoulder. When I approached a man, I'd be thinking, I wonder if I ought to get him first, or should I let him make a move? But I'd always come back without trouble. "Jesus, you made it back," he'd say. "Jesus, he made it," she'd say. That always made the beer and the cigars taste better. All right, whose deal was it? Did the dog crap? Sure, they always crapped for me. Tragic things were always happening to these people. How they ever got a book out, nobody ever knew. I'd sit down, gulp at the beer, deal the cards. "Listen, did I ever tell you about the one who claimed I jacked off in a bathtub?" "Did you? All right, ante up."